Welcome back to Living 808. Well, we've told you that the slippers at Island Slipper are made locally, but today we're getting a behind-the-scenes look at exactly how. John takes us on a tour.
Our good friends at Island Slipper have invited us down to the factory once again here in Pearl City, which means local people, local jobs, and everything made right here in Hawaii. Matt Carpenter, the owner, is gonna give us a grand tour.
Hey, John, how's it going?
Good to see you. Thanks for having me down. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to taking the grand tour, but since we're here, let's start off here first. Made in Hawaii for more than 75 years, Island Slipper, this is the place where it's all happening.
This is the place. This is the factory, the warehouse where it all is made, yeah.
So what do we have behind us? I see you're putting down some fabric.
Actually, this is suede. Okay. So we've got a whole bunch of different leathers and suedes here, fabrics. We've got all raw materials, and then we start to cut it and make all the custom different styles that we make here.
You mind showing me a little bit about the process?
Yeah, sure, sure.
Okay. All right, so where are we at right now?
Well, right here, we're in the cutting department. So, okay. You know, we've got our raw materials here.
So this is what you had laid down on the shelf?
Yeah, it's a piece of it. Yeah, it's a okay. Leather. And we go ahead and we cut all of our insoles where your feet sit, the strap work, all the upper portion of the slipper is cut right here.
Where are we going next?
Why don't we head over to where all the kind of straps are made.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, what we got here is we got some of the leather that we saw earlier. It's been converted into straps so that we're ready to, you know, start making the uppers for all the different slippers we make here.
So many different colors and types. The spools we just saw were completely filled. Hers is nearly empty. She's working.
Yeah, she is. So what she's doing is she takes the full spools and all the different lengths based on sizes. They'll start to cut your order, and they have to cut out all the bad pieces because not every section is usable. And they're trained to learn to look for it and then match the colors because you got different dye colors and stuff like that, even within the same color, you know. No two browns are always the same, no two grays.
So from the straps, they go where?
The insoles will be ready to go to their next step.
Okay, let's do it.
Yeah, so Julie here is starting to finish the insoles. After they're cut and glued, she's going ahead to finish the edges here, trying to get ready for the final assembly.
Where are we going next?
Let's see how the straps are made.
Let's go. So this is the next step.
Yep, next step here is strap making. After you saw they cut it, Bing over here, she's starting to sew the straps together. Mm-hmm. And then May over here is actually pairing the, remember I talked about the different colors?
Yeah.
They got to pair it together, learn to look at the different colors. They match each pair, and then they start to, you know, she's assembling it. After this, we'll take the finished insoles, and we'll go ahead and put our Island Slipper label on it.
Ooh, yeah. I like that. Let's go check it out.
So over here, you've got Mrs. Silva. She's labeling our shoes here. Basically, it's a heat transfer. We label everything on our insoles, leather, suede, ultra suede. Gets our label, our signature mark.
Super important to put the logo on your slippers. Now, the last time I was here, it was before the pandemic, and this is actually one of my favorite parts. I call it the PP part, pairing and pulling. But first, let's talk about the pairing.
Yeah, so over here, after all the raw materials are put together, the uppers and the insoles, then we go ahead and we pair the uppers and insoles based on the order and the different colors and get it ready to go over to, well, they are physically pulling the strap through the insole, but you know, assembling the product, right? They're getting the product ready for the assembly line.
But you wanted to laugh. I know you wanted to laugh. Let's check that out. Like I said, this is one of my favorite parts because you're using a pair of pliers in such a clever way because it works.
It does. And when the power goes out, Richard can still work.
Ah, good job, Richard.
So John here from the PP section, okay. As you said, we're over here at what we call lasting or fitting. Mm-hmm. So over here you can see Rudy and Zaldi, they are going to hand fit each product. So they take out a foot last for each size and they go ahead and pull the strap. And with a little bit of adhesive that is, you know, pre-applied to it, they can go ahead and fit and then they can check each product.
Wow, so they have a size foot that they need to stick into the slipper to make sure that's the right size for
it. Correct.
Ah, what's next?
Next would be the final assembly. They're gonna press the completed upper and the outsole, and then that's pretty much it.
Show me, sir.
Okay.
These guys are hammering away.
They are, literally, right?
So what's going on here?
Yeah, so over here is basically what we call sole pressing. It's the final assembly. What you hear, the hum in the background, that's our heater. It's bringing the insole and outsole together, reactivating the heat, and then you got Ariel over here He's sticking it together to get it fitted, and then Otto is going to head to kind of just pound the edges with the hammer, just kind of seal the edges, and then lastly in the back it goes onto a sole pressing machine where it then gets pressed together with kind of like a high pressure, you know, to hold it all together.
The important thing here is you have local people doing local jobs, and it's important for a human to be doing these things.
Yeah, you know, because we're handmade locally in Hawaii, we're always looking for people to come and join our team.
So how do they, if somebody's interested in maybe working for you guys or working for Island Slipper, how do they get in touch with you?
Simple. Easiest way is to email career@islandslipper.com.
And of course, you can always go to Island Slipper for your favorite pair, either the third floor at Ala Moana Center or the second floor at the Royal Hawaiian Center. Matt, thanks for having me down. I appreciate it.
Thanks again, John. Take care.
That's so neat.
And good job by Ethan editing this, because if you could tell that our voices changed at the end, that machine was actually really loud, so he kind of hummed it down a little bit. But so much fun, and it was nice to be able to meet all of the folks that are actually doing all the jobs.
Right.
And they're doing such a great job. They're putting together a bunch of stuff. And of course, yeah, my favorite part was the pee-pee part.
As we would expect. I mean, we're both like 12. We both laughed during that part when he said it. I was like, But hey, that's the behind the scenes look at how those awesome slippers are made. And you know, you hear locally made, but to actually see all of the local workers
all the different parts
behind it. And the whole process, it's really cool to see.
It really is.
So thanks for the tour.
Yeah, you're welcome.
All right, well, coming up next, you guys.